Across the southern grain-growing region, the spreading of urea fertiliser is a familiar sight during the season. A GRDC-funded investment looking at how irrigated farming systems in the northern and southern region can become more profitable has investigated how much nitrogen is optimal and when it should be applied.
These are really drained nicely, and I think we could get some good samples out of this.
Managing Director of Field Applied Research Australia, Nick Poole, led the project's research program.
When we started the Optimising Irrigated Grains program, there was a focus on, well, sky's the limit in terms of, you know, how much nitrogen fertiliser we should be putting on to achieve much higher yields.
What Nick Poole's research team found is that there is a tipping point over which there's limited benefit to applying more urea.
What's an overwhelming aspect of the project is, at the end of the day, probably no more than 200, perhaps exceptionally 250 kilos of nitrogen is the maximum we've found, beyond which we're not getting a return.
The trials looked at irrigated canola, chickpeas, grain maize, durum and breadwheat, faba beans and barley. There were comparisons between applying rates of zero nitrogen right up to 500 kilograms per hectare. That equates to almost a ton of urea, which is a soluble compound made up of 46% nitrogen. The NDVIs, or greenness of the crop, were tested throughout the season, with this more traditional ground-based scanning of individual plants, but also with a drone, which can get a broader reading of the whole trial and compare the various applications. It emerged the health and fertility of your farming system plays a crucial role in how much nitrogen should be added and when.
The importance of knowing what nitrogen you've got in the soil is of paramount importance. You need to know what that is at the start of your season. It may be that you followed a legume crop, or you followed a crop where there was a lot of excess fertiliser that didn't get used. Knowing what available nitrogen you've got at the start of your season actually gives you some idea of not only how much top-up of nitrogen you might need with fertiliser, but when to apply it.
The research agronomist says you have to look at your whole farming system and replace nutrients such as nitrogen that you remove, particularly if you're growing high-yielding crops. In irrigated systems, you do have more control over the uptake of nitrogen.
We can be more effective with slightly later applications of nitrogen than we would be in a dryland sense, where we're always worried about the spring drying out on us.
Nitrogen can mineralise and become available over the course of a season, and that happens more readily in a fertile, irrigated farming system.
When soils are wet and warm, we tend to mineralise more of that nitrogen than we would in a dryland sense. So warm, wet soils mineralise larger amounts of nitrogen, provided the farming system has that nitrogen in the bank, so to speak.
This project also included an on-farm component.
When do you think you'll be getting that out?
Oh, I think it'll be ASAP.
Brendan Wallis facilitated an action learning group around Francis, halfway between Bordertown and Narracourt on the SA-Vic border.
There was 8 action learning groups scattered between Victoria, New South Wales, Tasmania and South Australia. And we were sort of the link between the agronomic research investment and the economic farm scale.
There were focus paddocks established on farms, so growers could test out some of the suggested applications on a larger scale than just the small trial plots. Wayne Hawkins at Francis hosted one of them.
We set up a demonstration site using farmer-owned equipment, and we applied varying rates of nitrogen from 0 kilograms of urea right up to 600 kilos of urea, which is quite an extravagant rate, to see if we found a tipping point where we maximise grain yield.
There's some really huge rates and some good normal rates that farmers use, so It was good watching all the results come out of all that.
Interestingly, the focus paddocks largely replicated what was happening in Nick Poole's trials, where 200 to 250 kilograms of N was around the maximum amount required.
Going above those limits, we did see protein responses. However, it then comes back to an economic justification. Is it worth going out chasing additional protein, particularly in bred wheat? Durum wheats, yes, absolutely, where you get paid for your protein. But bred wheats, if you're pushing for above 11.5% protein, the investment's not justified because of the additional cost in the nitrogen to get there.
And he emphasises you can't manage what you don't measure.
So conducting pre-season nitrogen tests is important to start to build the picture of what your end budget is. And then you can then build on that with applied nitrogen to a target yield.
Timing of fertiliser application is also critical.
We know that if we over-fertilise our irrigated crops too early and they're already have the potential to be well-fed, we create a crop canopy that is too thick, and that excessive early fertiliser leads to crops that potentially lodge or fall over, making harvest that much more difficult. But also, because the crop is so thick, excessive humidity that can increase disease pressure.
The researchers say the information gained from this project is particularly applicable to growers of durum wheat under irrigation. Following the right timing and amount of N makes it easier to achieve quality durum, particularly protein specifications. Brendan Wallis emphasises, in addition to measuring and maintaining a healthy farming system, good old-fashioned walking through the paddocks and scouting crops is still essential, so the plants can tell you whether they need a nitrogen feed.
I think farmers have been applying nitrogen over and above what is required. They've been applying nitrogen as in terms of the more you feed it, the more yield you get. Instead of refining that and actually identifying what are our potential yields, what's our starting nitrogen level, and then feeding it to a level which is achievable.